hold on to your hat. This is going to get nasty. The nastiness started when President Trump was asked about things Meghan Markle said about him as a candidate.
As misogynistic as Trump is and so vocal about it.
She said she'd move to Canada if you got elected. Turned out she moved to Britain.
What can I say? No, I didn't know that she was nasty.
He also praised her, saying it's nice to have an American princess and he's sure she'll be excellent. Then in a tweet, the president said, I never called Meghan Markle nasty.
No, I didn't know that she was nasty.
He later called the mayor of London nasty after the mayor wrote a harsh op-ed about him. President Trump is pretty much an equal opportunity attacker when it comes to flinging the word nasty. He's called Marco Rubio nasty as well as Jeb Bush and Ted Cruz, even his current buddy Lindsey Graham. But most famously, he used the word to describe Hillary Clinton during the same debate in which he said,
nobody has more respect for women than I do. Nobody.
But when Hillary made a crack about Trump avoiding paying taxes,
assuming he can't figure out how to get out of it, but what we want to do is to replenish the Social Security Trust Fund.
Nasty woman became a badge of honor, plastered on hats and T-shirts.
Go to HillaryClinton.com and buy a limited edition Nasty Woman mug.
Trump has made nasty references about Elizabeth Warren and the mayor of San Juan, Puerto Rico, who responded by wearing the insult.
Sobre mí fue que I was a nasty mayor, ¿verdad?
But now there's a new nasty woman. After Kamala Harris grilled the attorney general.
Yes or no, please, sir.
The president dropped the nasty bomb on Harris twice.
Well, she was probably very nasty. A little bit of a nasty wit.
What's that about?
God only knows.
Clearly, nasty is one of the president's best words.
Such a nasty woman.
Genie Mo, CNN.
Nasty, nasty boys.
New York.